Hello, good morning everyone. Back with me again, Adi from Black Soldier Fly Colony. And today I will share to you about the life cycle of flies, black soldier flies. So stay with me during this video till the end. I'm at home, and due to the coronavirus and during the situation is not safe, I'm home a lot. But as I promised to you to keep update videos in these channels, I made a simple setup at home just to keep showing you about the cultivations of black soldier flies. And guys, right beside me is my first flies cage, which is I made it about 6 years ago. I used to use this cage for some observations of cultivations since about 6 years ago. And of course this is not the cage like on my farm that I use for maggot productions. Where my farm, the area of the cage is adjusted to the maggot productions target every day, and all are integrated one and another's. So step on the cycles of cultivations running on the good procedures. What I want to share here is about one of the cycle in maggot cultivations. One of step on the cycle is to cultivate of flies in the cage like this. Guys, this black soldier flies does not eat for its entire life, but only drinks, unlike the house flies. So black soldier flies not disease factor, and these guys are environmental friendly. You can give them a drink by spraying water like this, and if your cage is small, we can spray the water from outside of the cage. Its life cycles begins when they hatch or emerge from seedlings called prepupae or pupae. Its life cycle is short, only 7 days. This is a pre-pupae, that's a seed that we put in the bins and keep in the cage. In about 14 days from pre-pupae, they will hatch into flies and start their life cycle. Some will do mating, where male will die after mating and female will die after laying eggs. After we see some couples getting married, certainly there are already females who will be ready to lay some eggs. And we must immediately prepare an attractant for females to lay their eggs. Like this. This is an attractant media where female will be attracted to the smell of the media, which they consider as a food. Even though they are don't eat, the female has instinct that knows that her baby larvae will need food while they hatch. And because of that the female will put eggs around the food, and this is the attractant is what they will consider as a food. On top of this attractant line, we put sheets of wood like this that is given a distance to make a gap like this. And the gap is about 3 millimeters, and in these gaps the female will lay their eggs. In the productions orientations, this activity maintaining the pupae Maintaining the seeds inside the cage and harvesting the eggs is daily routine activity. And your maggot production target every day will determine the measurement of the cage, and it will determine the egg target that must be produced every day, and also will determine how many pupae we must maintain in the cage. Okay guys, hope this video is useful for you, and don't forget to watch the other video in my channel, and hope this video is also useful for you. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell, because it will make you keep updated. Yeah. And see you in the next video, where I will hatch these eggs and show to you how we prepare the nursery. And okay guys, see you in the next video. Thank you, bye.